Hello everyone, my name is Hermet. Today I'd like to introduce the inventor which is also known as Enlightenment EDC Editor Tool. This is a sort of script editor tool that supports text editing and previewing functions for the EDC source code. So, for example, when your application requires a real-time change of layout like animated ones, then you can write those layout design using EDC script and compile it into the EDC .pomlet file and import the EDJ into your application using UI layout component. And this inventor helps you write EDC script easier and finish your work task faster. But I want to tell you about EDC grammar or programming method in this video. If you are not familiar with EDC script, then please go to the Enlightenment site, official site www.enlightenment.org and see the documentations and examples. Then let's take a look at the screen. You can see the Inventor 1.0, which was just released. Basically, this tool layout is consisted of text area and live area here. Whenever you modify the source code, then you can see the result instantly like this. If I change the position of this image with this like this, or maybe you can change this rectangle part, its color to another one like this, or probably you may need to change the text. And this inventor displays the result instantly like this. And if you look at the right side of the view, then here is the EDC navigator, which displays the hierarchy of the GUI layout. Normally, one layout is consisted with multiple graphical component parts like image, text, and solid color. And here examples has image part and solid color and text part and etc. And this EDC navigator displays its information like this. If you look at the bottom area here, then you can see a traditional file tab function, and below it you can see the status bar, which displays the peripheral information. And if you click this button, and you can control a slider to zoom in out of a preview like this. And if you click this button, then here more additional sliders, you can use them to change the view size like this. And right over that, here button is designed to simulate the situation, the scenario actually, for the mobile device rotation. So if you click this button, then the size of the width and height will be switched like this. And new things from the previous version is this is this file browser. From the 1.0, you can open and close the EDC files in the tool directory. But it may display the previous like this, but don't surprise it because it's intended. Rather than this, you may need to press F2 key. To open a new file, plus set the file to a main EDC file. Then Inventor displays the preview of the new opened file. And once the file is set to main, then you can see the main tag in the file name like this. sometimes applications need to consist of main collection with multiple EDC files. In this case, you can also enjoy it with Inventor. So let me show you one more example. Okay. Here I opened one sample that actually EDCs are written for Inventor theme itself. So here Inventor.edc file is the main entry file for this Inventor theme data. And actually this EDC file has more additional sub EDC files like this. And if you want to open these sub EDC files, then just press F3 key. Just after place the editor cursor on the file name and just press F3 key, then it opens the file. And you can go back to the previous file quickly by just pressing F4 key. So just remember F3, F4 are used for navigate the files. So I open the layout setting and I see the setting layout group here, and basically the new group is opened with the size 300 by 300. So if you need to change the view size, then using these sliders. And in default, actually the Inventor displays the wireframes of the each part. So you can toggle on off the wireframes by this button, but if the wireframe is enabled, then you can see the boundaries, visual boundaries of the each part, and this helps you to understand the layout design and each the boundaries of the parts and their positions. So it's very useful actually. And sometimes reference verbs may help you to understand the grammar. Just to set a focus onto the one on keyword, then press F5 key. Then Inventor shows a pop-up that describes the keyword like this. So if you're not familiar with the EDC script yet, then you can use this reference pop-up using F5 key. And finally, let's take a look at the live edit function. So I open a new list item here. So this example shows you example of the list item, and I'd like to add one graphical part here. So I just press the image part in the tools area. Actually, here are some preserved parts: rectangle text image and swallow text block space, etc. Then you can just press one part to insert it, and just and drag and drop like this. But in this case, this I'd like to place this part just the left side of this image. So I set a fixed size, each size, and set each position to relative two of the this rock image, and also like this. And to confirm this, your To confirm the edit, then just press enter or double click it. But its size is not perfectly correct, so I need to change the size by modifying the source code like this. Then new image part is placed here, and I can change the image source, but I didn't prefill actually, so I just reuse the another image resource like this. And let's check. Let's change the image size. Change the size. Okay, it looks pretty nice. Then I can save the result into one sample here. And I can launch the one sample applications actually that loaded the list item wizard. So like this. So so far we've looked the Inventor 1.0 briefly, and thank you for watching. I hope you like and enjoy this tool, and if you have any questions, then please send me a mail. Thank you.